everybody, it's Martin again. Today I'm doing another Tarpon Fly. It's a simple classic, the cockroach. Very, very simple fly to tie. Requires very few materials. The hook I'm using is a Tiemco 600 SP. This is a size 2/0, but you can tie them a range of sizes. Here, I mean, I've gone down as small as a 1. Here, you could tie them up bigger as well. I'm just using Uni Big Fly. Use 3/0, whatever you like. Just use whatever suits the size of fly you're tying. Just running a bed of thread the full length of the shank. I'm going to stop sort of just at the start of the bend in line with the barb. Now I'm going to add a wee bit of flash. Just using root beer crystal flash. I've got 4 or 5 strands. I'll fold them in half. Tie them in the length that I like. Two shank lengths. I sort of just judge it with this part of my vise. You know, you can use your vise as a measure. And I'll just fold the butt ends back there, just to add a bit more. This might look like quite a lot of flash for a tarpon fly, but you can always trim it out when you're fishing if the fish are sort of shying away from it. So I'm just matching up 4 grizzly hackles. I'm using, this is actually white and American hackle. Which is good for your saltwater flies, are nice and big well marked feathers, good consistency across the saddle or the neck, whichever you use. I'd really recommend them, they're not that expensive either, they're only about $30. Which I mean, when even just a standard Chinese neck now, you're starting to get, well, if you're using like the big ones, they're like 15, 16 maybe, so These are really good value. They're very dense capes with a lot of feather on them. Anyway, so I'm going to tie these in again, just the same sort of basic. Excuse me. Just the same measure, slightly longer than the crystal flash, and then you can just a couple of wraps just lets you adjust them. Make sure they're sort of sitting nicely splayed, same length, and then you can wind crank down on them, tighten them up, lock them in place. And then just tidy up, create a nice base to tie on. At this stage I just like to give it a wee lick of head cement. Just to add a bit of security and a wee bit of durability. And the collar of this fly, it's natural brown bucktail. You just take the stuff from this at the middle of the of a white bucktail, and you got a fair clump for this size of fly. You know, you want fairly good coverage. You can always sort of line it up and see. You might want to add some more, depending on how it looks at the density of the sort of middle chunk of bucktail sort of varies quite a bit from tail to tail. So I'm just sort of I'm not going to stack it, but just roughly, if you hold it loosely between a couple of fingers and just tap it, you get it roughly aligned. You don't want a hard edge of it. If I'd stacked it, I just want a sort of rough alignment. If any that are just a bit too long, you can just pull them out and set them back in. Nice colour, that looks quite good. I might need to add a bit more. That's it anyway. So, I mean, this is sort of up to you, but I would say you want the collar sort of coming about a third to a half of the way back of the your hackle feather, and just grip everything. Take one big loose wrap, and that will sort of help encourage the fibres around the shank, and then tighten down. Just have a quick check that you've got full coverage, which I have. Just come in and trim this away. Sure, the rotary vise is really useful. Now, if you notice, I've trimmed it trimmed the butts at slightly different lengths. That just helps you have helps you to taper into the nose rather than just having a single bump. It makes your thread work a bit easier. Right, that's nice and tightened up. So just before again for a wee bit extra security, get some head cement in there. The deer hair compresses anyway, but it just gives you a nice wee bit of extra grip, and just run your thread along and come back, just touch and turns just to make sure everything's nicely covered up. Okay, so the last thing to do with the thread is just throw on a quick finish. You can do this by hand or use a tool, it's up to yourself. Now, you could leave it like that. I know a lot of people just tie cockroaches without eyes, and that's fine. The original had like painted eyes, with acrylic paint or whatever. But I'm just going to use a flat tape eye. You know, so that I'm not really adding any weight or anything. But I'm still getting that nice eye feature. I sort of feel like it's not going to do any harm. And an eye's, you know, definitely a trigger feature. So these are, what size is he? 7:30 seconds for this size. Just got to glue them on right at the start of the wing. I've already just put a wee spot of super glue on the thread there, just to help grip it. And then I'll do the same on the other side. What sometimes happens with the tape eyes is when you stick them onto a curved surface like this, you sometimes you sometimes lose some of the black stuff, the pupil. But that's easy enough fix, you just use a black marker. You can see there I'll just spot that in. There you go. That one's okay. And then just to finish the fly, I'm going to give it a coat with some UV resin. I mean, if you still use epoxy, use epoxy. But this stuff's just so much cleaner and quicker. This is Loon I'm using, but you could use Clear Cure Goo, Deer Creek or whatever. But I think Loon is the best. Closely followed by Clear Cure Goo. So, whoever is that with my lamp. I'm going to need to give it a wee bit more resin. Just to build it up around the eye slightly. That's the beauty, I mean this is the beauty of the UV resin. You can just cure it, see what it's like. And come in. Add a bit more. Until you get the shape that you're after. Quite that good. Give it a few seconds with a lamp, that sets it up nice. And then what I like to do with the flies that I've finished with the Loon is I just stick them in a piece of foam and leave them in direct sunlight for a while, just to give it a full cure, sort of bake it and take the sort of tacky residue feeling off. Right, I hope you liked that. If you did or if you didn't, leave a comment below. Let me know what you thought. Let me know what kind of flies you would like to see tied. And don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you didn't. Right. Thanks very much, guys. Bye.